Hey guys, what's up? In this video today, I'm going to show you simulation of class C commutation in Proteus software. So this is a circuit of class C commutation. Here I have used 12 volt DC supply as an input supply to this circuit. An LED is used here as a load. A capacitor is used as a commutating element. A resistor of 2000 ohm with a DC ammeter to measure current is connected in this arm. This is our main SCR and this one is our auxiliary SCR. This circuit here is used for the triggering of main SCR and this circuit here is used for the triggering of auxiliary SCR. I have used push to on switch here and here to momentarily apply gate trigger to the thyristors. So without wasting any more time, let's get this simulation started. Initially, this main SCR is triggered and current starts to flow in the circuit through the path V positive J LED anode cathode, node T main SCR anode cathode and back to this V negative. And second current flows through the path V positive node J, node K, R1, node P capacitor, node T main SCR anode cathode and back to V negative. So initially I am going to trigger this main SCR first by pressing this button. Now as we can see, load is turned on and at the same time this capacitor is started charging through this resistor R1, and also we can see that as the capacitor is getting charged, the current is decreasing in this ammeter. So we'll wait for this capacitor to get fully charged. And when this capacitor gets fully charged, then this current is going to be zero. So this current is now zero. It means that this capacitor is fully charged. Now this circuit will remain in this same state as there is no path for the capacitor to discharge. And our load remains in the on state as long as the input supply is connected to this circuit. Now to turn off this main SCR, we need to trigger the auxiliary SCR. When this auxiliary SCR is triggered, the capacitor is directly connected to the main SCR. This left plate of the capacitor, which is negatively charged, is connected to the anode of main SCR, and right plate of capacitor, which is positively charged, is connected to the cathode of main SCR. Thus the reverse voltage is applied to this main SCR, and because of this reverse voltage, this main SCR suddenly switches to the off state. Now to turn off the main SCR, I am going to trigger this auxiliary SCR by pressing this push button. Here you will observe that as soon as I press this button, the load is turned off as the main SCR is switched to the off state and the capacitor is charged with reverse polarity. So I am going to hit this button now, and as you can see, this load is turned off and the capacitor is charged with reverse polarity. Also we can see that this auxiliary SCR is in conduction state as the constant current of 6 mA is flowing through it. Again, this circuit will remain in this same state as there is no path for the capacitor to discharge. And the circuit remains in this same state as long as the input supply is connected to this circuit. Thus by triggering this auxiliary SCR, we have achieved commutation of main SCR. Now if we want to turn on the load again, simply we need to trigger this main SCR. As the main SCR is triggered, the left plate of capacitor, which is positively charged, is connected to the cathode of auxiliary SCR, and the right plate of capacitor, which is negatively charged, is connected to the anode of auxiliary SCR. Because of this, reverse voltage is applied to this auxiliary SCR, which switches it to the off state. So now I will trigger this main SCR by pressing this button, and as we can see, our load is turned on. At the same time, this capacitor has started charging through this resistor R1, and also we can see in this ammeter, as the capacitor is getting charged, the current is decreasing. Now again, if we want to turn off main SCR, we will trigger auxiliary SCR, and the same cycle is repeated again and again. So it means that whenever we turn on the main SCR, the auxiliary SCR is turned off, and whenever we trigger the auxiliary SCR, this main SCR is turned off. So this is like they are complementary to each other, and that's why this commutation method is also known as complementary commutation method. So this is all about class C commutation, and if you learned something from this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. If you have any questions, post it in the comment section. Thanks for watching the video.
Press the bell icon on YouTube app and never miss another update.